Thank you very much, Dee. Good evening, Reading. How lovely to finally be here. I broke down on the way to the gig tonight, which was a bit embarrassing. Crying on the train. I'm actually in my late 30s, I'm 41. You can't get later than that. You can tell I'm a bit older than some of the younger fellas because I like to wear my trousers all the way over my buttocks. Yeah, I'm old school. It's always intrigued me, the low trouser fashion, because the rest of us who don't wear the trousers like that, we're just meant to accept it, aren't we? When we see a man go, oh right, you're going to wear them down there. Sort of below the actual, sort of below the bottom. It seems to defy all physics, doesn't it? You're thinking, how on earth is he keeping them up? One can only assume they're hooked over something. I just think if your trousers are below your buttocks, it's no longer a pair of jeans. It's a long pair of denim socks. So here we are then, credit crunch Britain, credit crunch. It's starting to kick in, but as you can see, we don't really care. We've responded to this in a very British way. We're just going to drink our way through this or something. I can't even remember where my house was. So some good news, Lidl have organic vegetables. Working behind the tills. It's just a joke. It's just a joke, sounds a bit cruel. I don't mean to be cruel, it's something that might upset any Lidl people that we might have. Have we got any Lidl people? It does sound like they've got quite a narrow employment policy. Are you little and tiny? Jump up on the top. I'd say a lot of people have a pop at Lidl, but it's one of those shops, you know, until you discover it, it's easy to mock it. But frankly, I don't know if you've been in there, but if you're looking for an aubergine and a fishing rod, that's the store for you, my friends. So, married people in the room, give us a shout. Sound tired. It's hard work, marriage, isn't it? It's quite hard work. I have to say, a few years ago, my wife suggested a trial separation, and I'll be honest with you, I thought it was going to work. Now, somehow, we clawed it back together. She gave me a list of things about me she wanted me to look into. Now, fellas, as you all know, that is never going to be a good list. She pointed out that even though I'm quite easygoing, I'm often very difficult on the way back. She says I've got a terrible memory. Now, I prefer to think of it as an information valve. Because I think once the male brain is in its 30s, it's already full. And then, and after that, it's a kind of one in, one out deal. When it comes to new information. She's asked me to record something off the telly for her at 7:30 on a Thursday evening. I'm forgetting our wedding in hers. She says I'm a procrastinator. Yeah, I had to go and look it up. Not immediately. See, that was an opportunity for the slightly cleverer people to demonstrate they know what procrastination means. If you're not sure, it's simply a posh word for bloke. Because it's putting stuff off, isn't it, to procrastinate, which is quite a male trait, fellas. We'll have to admit it, we do put stuff off. Ladies, there's a really good reason for this. It's because there's so many slightly more interesting things in the world to be doing than painting that door. 3 months my wife been asking me to paint the door. Why is she going to do it? God only knows. I'm all for equality, but apparently you have to have a penis to paint a door. You have to get aroused to do the top bit. I woke up one morning, fellas. You know that feeling, that DIY feeling? Not that one, the other one. You bought a new tool and you want to flip it using it. You think, I know, I'll paint the door, I can do that. But we just had the floorboard stripped down to the wood to prove that we weren't middle class. Carpets, it was gone. Seagrass, that's acceptable. I did want the paint dripping on the newly stripped floor, so I put lots of newspaper down, right, because that's the preparation part of the job, and that's what the ladies love, the preparation. You like the preparation. And it looked good. My wife was pleased because that looks like something's about to happen, so she leaves the room. She comes back an hour later. I'm reading the newspaper. You probably worked out by now I'm not a geezer. I've never achieved geezer status. I know some geezers and I like geezers. I'm not suggesting you're a geezer. You're a geezer, aren't you? He's a geezer. I'm a bloke. I've never achieved geezer status. I've always been on the periphery of mad culture. And I think that's because I use words like periphery. I met Uber Geezer quite recently. I think he may have been a Cockney fella. I don't think we've got any Cockneys in tonight. If you're not sure if you are a Cockney, by the way, simply look down. If you're covered in buttons, probably a Cockney. Or a Sky remote. Either way, you're probably not working. Officially. You've got to love the Cockneys, the eel's only natural predator. So me and this geezer, we're in a confined space. It's a small pub saloon room. I've detected a little bit of tension between me and him, so I suggest a conversation as a way forward in our burgeoning friendship. Pretty soon we're involved in a conversation. In fact, I seem to have been started like this. Yeah! Well, that appeared to be his opening gambit. I'm a patient man, I simply wait for some more information. He continues. Anyway! I said you can't start a sentence with anyway. You haven't said anything yet. Whatever. Finally, he gets into the meat of it. The economy's at the toilet here, mate. I said, what do you mean? He said, the economy, it's at the toilet. I said, what do you mean? He said, I've just heard on the radio, mate. There's only £1,000 left in the world. I said, no. Pandas. In the wild. I said, I think you'll find it's the ecology that's up the toilet. He didn't hear that bit because he had been a hit. Very soon. But you've been lovely, thank you very much for your indulgence and your time. Just wanted to tell you this, I joined one of those book groups recently in an effort to become a slightly more interesting person. Now unfortunately the first book we read was Chuck Palahniuk's Fight Club, which was later made into a movie with Brad Pitt. Now, as many of you will know, the first rule of Fight Club. Yeah, first meeting was...